So imagine over dinner in a few hours, I offer you a beverage featuring acetaldehyde and 2-furfuryl ethyl. Sounds and looks pretty scary, right? Especially with the tumbling molecules behind me. What if I add a little bit of caffeine? Would you drink it then, that beverage? For those of you who are thinking, absolutely not, the reality is that you've just turned down a fresh cup of coffee. A much-needed kickstart to many of our mornings, and if you're me, throughout the entire rest of the day. The point being that everything is chemistry, from the food we eat to the air we breathe, and the very makeup of our bodies is all composed of, well, chemicals. Atoms that are linked together in all sorts of different ways, shaping the potential for that chemistry to do good, or flagging the potential for not so good. Some of those chemistries say, hey, you know what? I'm probably going to stay in the environment for a really long time. In fact, your children's children's children are going to have to find a way to deal with me. And then there's other chemistries which say, hey, you know what? I'm going to quickly break down into some pretty friendly stuff. I'm going to be here today and gone tomorrow. So as we look at the world around us today and the stats that have all brought us here on waste and emissions, what if we actually selected for better chemistries in the first place? What if we took a step back and looked at sustainability through a molecular lens? That's exactly what we're doing in our R&D labs, or aiming to do in our R&D labs all around the world. So now imagine you're a product designer, or maybe a future technology investor. How do you keep pace with innovation and at the same time make responsible choices about that next big breakthrough? How that material is sourced, how it's manufactured, how it's packaged, without adding to the stats that we all continue to read about? How do you systematically do that amidst all of this complexity? And maybe more to the question, are you doing that? Now, 30 years ago, a very impressive thought leader published on the 12 principles of green chemistry, beacons that are really intended to guide all of us toward a sustainable future. While those principles remain just as powerful today as they were then, what I'm excited to share is how we've taken four of those broad concepts and principles and distilled it into a practical tool, a tool that enables product designers to make the best chemical choices they can every day. Now, the underlying algorithm, simplified here, links to the chemical properties of these raw materials and classifies the not so good, or the better, through the lens of human, environmental, and ecosystem health, culminating in a green score, a compass, if you will, that guides our product designers towards sustainability throughout the entire product development process. Now, we are so excited about this methodology that we actually published it in the Journal of Green Chemistry. And because of its broad applicability and the underlying robust approach, it was actually featured on the front cover. But I think what makes this truly beautiful, or the beauty of our score, is really actually best told by the way of our Aveda brand formulators, who sought to actually create a hair care treatment and repair line for all sorts of different hair types. And these same formulators leveraged our Green Score tool to select for chemistries of lower environmental impact. And through real-time analysis, they found that if they replaced a synthetic free radical-based polymer with a conditioning plant polymer, not only could we stay true to product performance that's critical to the botanical repair line, we could also, at the same time, reduce material use by 350,000 kilograms by 2023, with the primary byproduct of that polymer being water. That's just one example of the transformative change at play, how a brand's formulation philosophy, coupled with a robust and practical tool, has led to a fundamental shift in how we make our products on a molecular level. Now imagine something even bigger. What if every product designer, whether you're in foods, pharmaceuticals, or personal care, did the same? What if the global supply chain end-to-end had access to practical tools to make the best chemical choices they can every day. What if? Thank you.